Look at that. You can tell this guy didn't miss leg day. Yeah, this is punching, kind of. I start walking your way, you start walking mine. What's going on, guys? My name is The Wolf Price, and welcome back to another episode of Besiege Creations gameplay. To start off with, this map is called the Sandcastle, and I believe there's supposed to be some kind of objective here, because whenever you start it off, it shows all this stuff right here. Stop the ships from reaching the line, you must kill the pilot of each ship for it to stop moving, arrow keys aiming, C to fire, and R to reload. But whenever I start it off, I actually don't see anything here, so If nothing pops up within a few minutes, we'll just pull up our first creation. Let's go and zoom out here a little bit. I imagine there should be some kind of AI boats, right? Oh, there actually are boats coming. Oh, okay, yep, I see them right there. Okay, let's go and go back over here to our little cannon thing then. I believe it's just like some kind of turret inside of a thing. You guys see what it is here. Okay, let's go ahead and focus onto this block again. Zoom in a little bit. Now let's try to aim this bad boy up. Oh, it actually shows like where you're aiming too. Let's go to shoot C. Just like that. Did we hit him? I feel like we hit the boat at least. Let's go and get this guy over here. Oh, there we go. Yeah, you can definitely see when you actually hit them, it blows up the boat. That's so freaking cool. Okay, let's get this guy right over here. This guy coming up on me. I don't appreciate that, dude. Get out of here. I think I missed, but don't worry about that. Oh, you can actually aim up and down. Okay, that's probably what I was missing. There we go. Okay, that works a lot better. This is really cool, though. I thought that was just going to be a map, but it actually has like a mini game and everything. Let's go and take that guy out over there. This guy way off in the distance. Hopefully we can hit him. I don't know. I think these cannonballs drop, so you kind of had to aim up a little bit. I don't know. Something over there is exploding, and there seems to be a lot of people coming in. Let's go and reload real quick and just start fire. Oh, I accidentally hit the freaking spacebar button. You guys know if there's a chance for me to mess something up, I'm definitely going to do it. But let's go and just look around this map a little bit then, since we're waiting for those boats to come over. It looks like just some kind of thing here. And there's a bunch of different turrets here that you can choose from. That's pretty good. Little house up here on the hill because, you know, after you get done storing stuff, you want to go back home and just relax. And I believe the actual sandcastle is just that little thing over there. No big deal. Let's go and get back over to here and shoot a couple more of these boats because this is actually pretty fun. One for that guy over there. Get wrecked, dude. I just shot off a panel of your boat. How do you like that? You probably don't appreciate it too much. I can imagine I wouldn't. It's crazy how far this game has come just so quickly. You know, with the multiverse update, so many things have happened, so many new things can happen in this game because of it, and it's just absolutely amazing. I love it. Holy crap, but after a while, it seems like a lot of boats start coming in, especially way off of that distance over there. Why are these cannonballs not shooting very far? I don't know. Let's go and reload and shoot a couple more. There we go. Oh gosh, okay, yep, there they go. But yeah, after a while, there just starts to be so many boats that you really can't shoot them all off, and yeah, I think that's how you lose. But anyway, it's definitely very cool. Let's go ahead and pull up our first creation. Oh gosh, okay. Well, I was trying to pull up our last creation, but whenever I started off, that happened. I guess we need invincibility mode. Okay, yeah, it was just sticking in the ground a little bit, no big deal. But yeah, for our first creation, this one is called the Giga Machina. Now, this is from the Sensor Studios. Of course, you guys know he creates a lot of really awesome things. I will leave the link to his channel down below in the description. You guys should definitely go check him out. And yeah, it's basically just like a giant mech robot thing. Which I love robot things. I have ourselves lined up right in front of the sandcastle here, so when we start walking, we can hopefully run it over. Because why not? The thing I don't like about this map, though, is that it looks so gray and washed out. You guys see, it just looks like kind of crap. So, yeah, we're not going to be here too much longer just for this guy. Pretty standard, just 3 and 4 to walk him, so I believe it's like 1 foot and then the other. So let's go and just try to walk forward here. The main thing is I just want to destroy this sandcastle right in front of me, if we can. I at least see there's a dude down here, so I want to try to walk over him. There we go. Is that working? Oh, not really. I'm just kind of tripping on it. Well, okay. Oh, and the boats are actually right over here in my feet now. Not sure what they're doing over here. Oh, they just kind of knocked me out of the way. Dude, that was rude. Anyway, though, there are supposed to be some rockets on this guy. Let's try to shoot some of those off. This is 4, 5, and 6, so let's go and just try 4. Didn't work. 5, 6. Number lock. 4, 5, 6. Oh, wait, what's this? Oh, it's just moving the arm. That's weird. I just went ahead and moved on to the next map because that one was a little bit boring, you know, with the actual background details and stuff. There wasn't really much to look at, so this one is called Aldea Sheep. Now, we can go ahead and just fly past it real quick, and you guys can get a nice little picture all around it here. There's some kind of little tent village. Dude's doing the thing over there, as they do. This is some kind of platform that I'm not sure what it does, but okay. Kill 10 sheep. I would rather not because, you know, sheep are cute. I don't want to hurt little sheep. Yeah, basically, it's just a nice little floating island type thing. But what I'm really curious about is just this thing right here. Is that a teleporter? It might just teleport us to that island. So I'm going to try to walk onto it and just see if that works. Now, the only thing is that the creation is much larger than the map. And I'm not sure what we're going to do about this because it just doesn't seem like it'll fit at all. Oh, gosh. Okay, I'm going to break stuff. I know it. This is going to be a breaking day. We'll just go ahead and put him right over here. And let's just go ahead and start this off because I know this is going to go badly just because of, like, what's going on here. Get rid of the building block. Okay. How are you doing, buddy? Are you okay? Look how giant you are compared to the freaking island. You're pretty much as big as, like, everything on this map combined. Do you feel good about that? You look pretty good. That's all that matters. Let's try out those rockets again and see if we can get them to work. So we're just... Oh, okay, now they're working. Weird. Maybe I just wasn't noticing it in the last map because it could have just been too small and I just didn't see it. I'm not sure, but yeah, there definitely are some rockets there. Nice. One and two are to raise and lower the arms, so that is this thing over here. That's what I was confused by earlier. No big deal. He says one, two, and four, and five to punch, so I'm not exactly what he means by that. I'm gonna try like one and four at the same time, like that. Boom. How do you like that? That wasn't a punch. Okay, two and four, or something like this. Do a little bit of that thing. Yeah, this is punching, kind of. Oh crap, we've kind of fallen off the island. Okay, what else other controls are there? There's a camera, let's go and try that. Okay, so now still a first-person camera. Oh no, okay. It kind of looks like we're about to fall off, but at the same time, he's kind of hanging on. He's resilient. Look at that. You can tell this guy didn't miss like that. That's a freaking feat of strength. Look at those bones. Hard as steel. Yeah, since this thing is absolutely giant, let's go ahead and find something else, and maybe that will actually fit on this map, because, yeah, this is a little bit excessive, you know? I'll admit it. The joys of being a YouTuber. Recorded for 45 minutes and realized that only 13 minutes of the audio was kept. Oh man, isn't that just... That's just something to make you smile, isn't it? That just makes my day so much better, having to come back here and record another video. It just... Honestly, it does suck a little bit because my back hurts, but you know, that's just things I'll worry about for us. Don't even worry about it. I don't even know if I showed this thing yet, so if I didn't, this thing is called the Alberta Tank. It's just a giant tank thing. Pretty cool. But when you start it off, it does have these couple of rockets on the back here, which are actually propelled by cannons, I believe. I don't exactly know, but we'll just go and shoot a couple of these off. Sorry, this video is going to be a little bit, like, kind of cut and weird stuffed, because, yeah, that thing happened. I don't know exactly what you guys have seen, so I'm just kind of going to show things again, and just we're just going to have fun, okay? Shut up. Just shoot these off as just 1 through 5, and as you guys see, when they shoot off, they kind of look like a cannon is, like, launching them, because they don't really shoot straight or anything. They just kind of go whichever direction they want to go. Like, that one right there, it didn't even explode until the actual tip of it hit something. So, yeah, I'm not sure how they're actually propelled, but it's just really cool to me. I really like, oh, gosh. Oh, man. What just happened there? I don't even know. A whole bunch of lag, though, but... Okay, I don't feel like that was necessary. Now, since I can't do the exact same thing because that would just bore me too much, let's go ahead and actually do the objective of this map, because I didn't do that in the original video because I was just having fun destroying stuff. But there is an actual objective over here. As you guys see, there's some kind of little tank dude. It says, meet up with your comrades so they can call a bombardment. Oh, and I forgot to say this map is called the Town of the Captured, in case you guys were wondering about that. All the links will be down below in the description, of course. Let's go ahead and zoom in on this guy here. I think we were just a little bit too close, so let's go ahead and try to move up on him, and he should start to move now, right? Come on, buddy. Oh, there he goes. Yep, you guys can see he's starting to move, and I think he will actually shoot and fire at stuff as well, so I'm gonna do that too. Let's go and just aim up a little bit and shoot off one of these rockets. Oh, I accidentally hit the wrong button. Don't know what button that was, but it was a button. Okay, thanks for turning to lag as well. Let me go and just turn that down a little bit. Sorry about that. Onward to victory with this guy over here, and I believe there's actually supposed to be different enemy tanks around the map as well that can actually shoot you, which should be pretty cool. If we really can't move that well here, so we may just go to this other tank over here and just see what he does. Oh, he actually got blown up, right, as I was saying that. Okay, well, anyway, let's go ahead and check out this map a little bit more, and then we'll go ahead and move on to something else. This guy over here, he's a little tank. Look at him. He's just doing tank things, and he actually will shoot at you. I'll go ahead and demonstrate that. Well, I mean, it did kind of get demonstrated by this tank over here getting shot, but yeah, I'll go and do it with my own thing. There we go, you guys see. Oh, wait, what happened? Oh, I think I broke it because there's two turrets sticking out the front, and it should be shooting at me, but it's not. That's kind of weird. Oh, there it goes. Okay, so it shoots every once in a while, but yeah, it just... Oh, there goes another one. So yeah, it's not very good, but it does shoot at you, and it can destroy you. So, noted. But yeah, man, that just freaking sucks, because I had the whole video recorded, and I was having a good time. This is so much fun. I love this creation. I love the other creations I showed, but it's just... just going through it again, it's not as much fun, so let me go ahead and find a couple of new things, and I'll see you guys there. I've actually changed my mind. I think we're just going to play around and have some fun, and that will be the video, and we're still going to check out a couple of different creations, but it's just not going to be anything, like, you know, set in stone or anything. I'm not going to definitely check out a couple of other things. I might just check out this thing and blow up a bunch of stuff with it. I'm not sure, but either way, it's going to be pretty fun. I'm sorry, but yeah, this is just... Thanks for what we're on today. I'm doing my own thing. Now, this map's called Aldea's Sheep, and as you guys see, it's some kind of floating island map thing. And over on the other side, there's supposed to be a bunch of sheep and just different stuff we could shoot at. So we're going to get over here onto this platform and just shoot over at this island, because that sounds like fun. Come on, for being a tank, you really can't get over this little lump. Are you for real? Come on now. Okay, I think we could just shoot from here. Doesn't even matter. This game wants to screw me over? Fine. I can screw it back over. Oh crap, I didn't even mean to hit that, but it is Q and E to rotate the turret, and apparently 3 to fire that one. There it goes. Is it actually going to explode? I think it's a really long drop to the ground, isn't it? It's gonna take forever? Nope. Okay, there it is. But yeah, it's Q and E to rotate the turret, and X and Z to actually make it go up and down. So let's go and try to move this up a little bit, and we'll just go and shoot this off. This is one. We'll just go and shoot those two. Oh, wait. I didn't mean to shoot two of them, but yeah, whatever. Is it gonna hit anything? Not really. Okay, whatever. I wonder if we could actually hit it from right over here. We don't even have to get to the edge. Let's go and try to move this up just nice and high. Something like that. And rotate it over here. And just shoot. Maybe that should work. We'll just shoot all of them off because it doesn't really matter. Here we go. Well, why isn't the other one going? There it is. Okay. Please hit something. Oh, it actually did make it. Look at that. Oh, there goes a whole bunch of stuff flying up. Don't know what that is. Cool, though. And, yeah. Pretty nice. And for our last creation of the day, this one is called the Truxformer. And from the name, it sounds like a truck that transforms into a transformer. Sounds pretty good to me. To move it around with the arrow keys, no big deal. Let's just go ahead and make our way down here. Making our way downtown, walking fast, all that good stuff. Just to get down to a nice little flat area. Maybe these guys over here at the camp. Hey, you guys are going to be cool? You're not going to hit me, right? You're just going to chill. Good. Don't do mean things. It is Q to transform this bad boy, so let's go and just do this here. Whoop, there it goes. And it says if it falls over, just to press Q again, and it should stand it back up. But it seems like we're actually flying away. Oh, it's because I was holding Q. I didn't realize it until I was done saying the whole sentence. So yeah, if you hold Q, you probably will fly away just because of the weird mechanics in this game. Also, sorry about my voice cracking a little bit. It's just because I've already recorded so much and it's just all gone and it just makes me so sad. No, but for real, my voice hurts a little bit, so I do apologize for that. But let's go and try to move this thing with 1 and 2, just like this. Come on, buddy. You start to walk along. I start walking your way. You start walking mine. Okay, there we go. It's actually kind of working. It looks a little bit derpy, but... I mean, you can't really expect too much for a transformer. There's also a bunch of different weapons on this thing, so let's go and shoot all these off. This is a little bit of cannons there, crossbow, just like that, and flamethrowers. So pretty much all the weapons that you really need. You can also transform back into the car mode, so let's go and try this out. We are at a little bit of an angle though, so I'm not sure how it's going to work. It actually worked pretty well, considering. Not bad. And back to the transformer mode, because you might as well. And I believe there is one last thing, which is to fly this bad boy, because of course, you cannot have a transformer unless it flies, because... That's a new rule I just came up with. It is 0 to fly this thing, so let's go and try to fly here. And I think we had to release our foot, so... Oh wait, oh, there it goes. I thought it broke for a second, but no, we're good. And now we can just fly around like a transformer kind of thing. I don't know if we can actually control this, though. I'm trying to see if there's any kind of controls. Oh, wait, actually, we might have a little bit of control here. But I think that was just a coincidence because, yeah, this is... It doesn't aim or anything. Yeah, still very cool. And you can also fly in the truck mode as well, because why not? Because, of course, if you're going to be able to fly, you might as well be able to fly in both modes. There we go. It's just, you know, a flying truck. What more could you ever want? Yeah, I think that will be it for today's video of Besiege, guys. I hope you all did enjoy. If you did, make sure to leave a like down below and subscribe to join the pack, because we're pretty dang cool around here, if you guys ask me. And sorry if the video is a little bit short, or if there isn't really that many things in it. It's just because, yeah, like I said, I already recorded. My voice hurts, my back hurts, everything hurts. I'm just going to go sit down. You guys have a good day. And of course, all the links to the creations will be down below in the description, as well as the Sensor Studios channel. You guys should definitely go check them out. And yeah, other than that, thank you guys so much for watching and liking. I hope you have a great day. Follow your dreams, and I will see you guys in the next one. Take care, and stay awesome, guys.